Welcome everyone to another video series of Expert Matters only on ISBR Business School's official YouTube channel. Another video, another expert, but today's expert is my personal favorite. She's a leadership coach, genetic brain profiling consultant, soft skill expert, career growth enhancer, and expertise in one-on-one consultation. And several domains like critical thinking, problem solving, crisis management, and team building. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please welcome Ms. Hardika Rajdev with us. Welcome, Hardika.
Thank you. That really pepped me up, by the way. Thank you for that.
Thank you so much for joining the show today. Do you think people today lack soft skills, Hardika?
So I don't think people lack soft skills. What people really lack is the awareness that how important it is for them to really know these things, or for them to really implement these things, because soft skills is something which can really take them forward and help them to achieve their desired goals.
So how important is the awareness?
I would say, technically there are a lot of researches done, and you know they say that soft skills carries 90% and 95% compared to the hard skills part of it. And say, I feel it is an hand in glove thing where your technical skills and your soft skills carry equal importance. Though technical skills is going to be more on the end where theoretical implementation happens, but we are into a human race, right? So understanding and working towards people management is very important, and that is where soft skill plays a vital role. So whether it is your personal life or your professional life, this category needs to be filled for each individual.
Right. So what are the other skills one should develop to excel in their career?
So, this is a very, very vast and a wide question. It's very subjective, of course, Shruti, that, you know, what would be the other skills that would be required? Though other than soft skills, I feel if people can, move towards something which is like people management skills, administrative skills, personal development, okay, personal awareness. These things will work as in, icing on the cake when they combine both of it together and move ahead.
Right. So we have, as a management student, we have always listened from our faculties and teachers that soft skills are the hard skills for management students, because it plays a very vital role, and people will, in companies, when HRs will come for interview or companies will come for recruitment, they will choose you based on your soft skills, not on your technical skills, because they will train you on your technical skills. But soft skills is something on the basis of which they will hire you. So is it true?
100% true. And it is not only for management students, it is for any category, because what people see, every organization takes you as an investment. Okay.
Yes.
So when I invest in something, obviously I'm looking out for something which is the best, which suits for what I am looking for, right? So they are putting in a lot of money into each individual which they hire into, okay? Mm-hmm. And if these things are sorted, or if these things are in place, technical skills is something which anybody can get trained at any point of time.
Okay? Right.
So I just want to add on one more thing over here. There is another myth about soft skills, that it is something which only people who are into admin management, they require. No, people management skills is something required by anybody and everybody, from a child to an adult.
Yeah, that's really informative. So let's do one thing. Let's just dig on to one by one onto every skill. Let's start with communication. So how can somebody build an effective communication?
Okay. Again, as I told you, it it's a very vast topic. See, communication is the foundation to anything that we want to develop on or build on. Okay, because it's the right communication in the right manner, using the right mode, gets you the desired results. Okay, so there are a lot of parameters that you need to work on before you actually get to your goal. Okay, so communication, I would say that is the foundation to any kind of, relationship, whether you're getting into, again, whether it is personal or professional.
Hartika, I've seen so many students, in fact, my batchmates as well. They are incredible. They have absolutely incredible knowledge. They have so many ideas, so many skills altogether. But some people lack communication. So it's a barrier. They know a lot of things. They imagine they can create a lot of things. They have a lot of ideas, but they cannot communicate it well. Rather, a person who doesn't have good ideas, but has an effective communication, he excels. He doesn't know well, he or she definitely has no more creativity and ideas than the other person, but because of only communication, they excel. So how about those people who have a lot of creativity and ideas, but cannot build up their communication? What are the small tips you would like to give to them?
Okay. First of all, I would like to tell you that communication skills is not knowing English. Let's make it very clear with that, okay? Which is a common myth again in the market, that if I am a good communicator, it means that I am strong with the language part of it, which is not that, okay? Having said that, if I have to give you one tip, right? Simple tip which anybody can implement from this very moment to be a good communicator is, just keep the matter simple.
Okay.
You don't need to really use those high funda jargon words, or you really don't need to look into, the accent part of it, or, the way you are using your tonality or anything like that. If I have an idea which I want to present to somebody, keep it very simple in a layman's language, how you can explain it to them. You can please go ahead with that. So keep it very simple, because nowadays it's more of the accent, the more of the jargon words, or, the more of those high fundu English words that you can use. It's seriously not required. And the second thing, what I would really want to tell everybody, which again is of easy implementation, is listen to a lot of people. Okay. Be a good active listener, because the moment you actively listen, it's going to somewhere seep into you. And when the time comes, trust me, it will come back to you, and you yourself will be surprised. Oh my, I could do this. So these two things, if you begin with, trust me, it will work.
Right. So, okay. Definitely after watching these two tips and following these two tips in their life, everybody watching this video right now, they are definitely going to improve their communication skills. And they will thank you for that. I will add on to the comments. I will tag you in the comments.
Oh, that was so sweet. And definitely it is going to happen, because I personally have trained more than 15 to 20,000 students into it. So I can vouch on it and tell you.
Oh my God, that's incredible. This will help a lot of people. So now let's come on to team building. So what is team building exactly, and how is it helpful for management students? Because we are making this video for management students especially.
I'll just give you a simple example. Okay. You want to clap your hand. How are you going to do it? We'll do it on the screen, yes, so that everybody sees. Okay. How are you going to do it? You're going to clap this way?
Yes.
Right? If it is only this, can I still clap?
No.
No. This is exactly what is team building. You need to come together.
All right.
You really need to come together. Uh-huh. Because when you come together, the power is much more than when you're just alone.
Yes. Okay. Understood.
So take it very simple. Again, I'm telling you, I don't complicate life and things for yourself. I know management students, MBA, peer pressure, a lot of things are there on your head, corporates coming in, but just keep it simple to yourself. Remember one thing, you as an individual carry your own potentials.
Right.
You can enhance these potentials in a much better manner if you are a good team worker.
Yes, definitely. Okay, so coming on to conflict management now. What is conflict management and how is it beneficial for everybody to learn? Not just management students, everyone who is entering into corporate or being an entrepreneur or something.
First of all, this conflict management word itself is a contradictory word. Who will want to manage conflict? Tell me that.
Nobody.
Would anybody want to? Nobody would want to manage that, right? Absolutely. So it is too a bigger word to be used, but of course it's again a corporate jargon. Mm-hmm. So let's take it there, but then really don't go by the literal meaning of it. It's not conflict management. It is more of choice management that happens over there.
Oh.
Okay. It's more of choice management. It's not conflict management. Because if it is conflict, there will be no management because we both will never want to come on the same page.
Right.
Right?
Yes.
They will never want to come on the same page. It's as simple as it goes.
You have made it so simple, actually. In my head, conflict management was something you are in a situation of crisis and you're not able to solve anything. But now you have made it everything step by step easily.
Yeah, because it was a very big word that was given to you. So your brain immediately was like, oh my God, it's a conflict. Itta bada ho gaya, right? And the same thing, if I would have just told you, it's just a matter of choice. Make this or make that or don't make a choice. Leave it. It's made it so easier for you to handle that, right? And as I told you there, it's a contradictory combination of words that have been used over there. Because if we both are on a conflict, we will not want to come on the same page at all.
Yes, yes. Hardika, firstly, soft skills, importance of soft skills, technical skills, then effective communication tips, team building, helpful for management students, conflict management, everything you have made it so simple and clear today. I really hope everybody will understand from this video very simply. We have almost come to an end of the video right now. So my last question will be, what are the skills you suggest anybody to retain in their life?
Okay, see, again, this is a very subjective thing, but on a common grounds, if you're able to, enhance your communication skills, your team building skills, okay, and at the same time, your time management, okay, things would fall in place towards the kind of goal that you're looking out for.
Wow. Yes. I was about to ask you a one line of motivation at the end of the video, but you have already told it. But now again, one line of motivation for everybody watching this video right now.
Okay. From the beginning till now, I've been saying that just keep it simple.
Right. So we will keep it simple. What I'll do is I'll write in the description of the video, Hardika said to keep life simple. We'll do that. Yes.
Absolutely.
So it's almost the end of the video. Thank you, Hardika. Thank you taking our time and sharing such beautiful information with us.
Pleasure is mine, Shruti. And I was really looking forward to connect with you. You're a bubbly little one and all the best to you and to all your peers.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate your time and efforts and energy. And this is so late we are recording this video, but really appreciate your time. Thank you so much.
Same here. Thanks a lot. Take
Bye-bye.
Care and See all you. The best.
See you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
All the
Bye-bye.
Best.
Bye-bye.